Welcome to First Aid Air Guy. I'm your host, Lou, and today we're going to be doing a long-term update review on the Ruger Airhawk. I had one of the somebody on the old intranet there ask if the gun was holding up, after I had first reviewed it. It'd been, I think, about 8-9 months later, something like that, and asked if the gun was still doing well because they were just purchased one and saw a lot of bad reviews. I actually have this gun now a little over 2 years now. I've got thousands and thousands of rounds through it. I don't know how many exactly, but I do all my primary testing through it. And so far, the gun has held up. I've lubed it up a couple of times, you know, a little bit of chamber lube oil, and then of course, the hinges, make sure everything's tightened down. I haven't had any problems. Still shooting in the 950s, I believe, should be around 900, 950 with a 7.4. But what we're going to do is we're going to take this bad boy, we're going to do a quick review, and test it out with the 7.4 destroyers, and then we're going to do a max velocity test as well. It's already done it once, but we want to make an official video for it. Just a quick reminder, it is all wood, adjustable trigger, it is a single shot break barrel, 1.177 caliber. I like the fact that it has a automatic thumb safety. For me, if you're going to have an automatic safety, it's convenient for me with the thumb. It doesn't bother me at all. I know it bothers some people, but to me, I like it. The trigger safety is a little more clumsier for me, especially if you're wearing gloves or something. So if you're going to have a safety, I kind of like it back here. That's just me, but you know, to each his own. Like I said, if you're going to have an automatic safety, I like it back there. So that's pretty much the gun in a nutshell. You can go back and watch the original review for it on my channel there. I'll try and put a link to it. I don't know. I just want to show you the performance I'm still getting a little over 2 years later, thousands and thousands of rounds through it. It's my primary workhorse. Only complaint is the Ruger 4x32 scope that it did come with. It lasted quite a long time. I've been beating the heck out of it, but the turrets are starting to take a crap on me. They're getting a little crunchy feeling. It's still holding zero, but when I gotta adjust it, I get a little crunchy feeling, so I'm sure it's not long until we gotta get rid of that. Let's get to it. Let's start off with the Crossman Destroyer, a 7.4 grain. Let's do a chronograph test, then we'll do a 10-yard accuracy test. Then we'll do a little ballistics, and then you know what time it is. Let's check it out. .920, not bad. .6 gel Ruger Airhawk destroyers. Look at that. That is the destroyer. That is a nice wound channel. And she ends up stopping right there.
You know what time it is. It's my favorite time. It's time to shoot some clay.
Here's a few reasons why I do like the destroyer pellets. Look at the shrapnel left behind. As you can see, three pieces left behind in the clay, still managed to get into the gel, and it's deformation too. So it's releasing energy everywhere. And you know what? These things ain't too expensive to boot. If you look at this group being shot, it looks bigger than it is. Still ended up being a half inch. Almost 14 foot-pounds of energy, half inch center to center. Not bad. Well, there you go, man. The Ruger Airhawk, after 2 years and thousands of rounds, is still blasting them 7.4 destroyers at around 920. I'd say 920 to 950. You're getting right around 13, 14 foot-pounds of energy. Still shooting a half inch dime-sized group at 10 yards. That's good for me. But that's part one of this review. Part two is the official max velocity test. So we're going to use the Winchester 4.32 grains, lead-free pellets. We're going to blast them out of there, see how fast we can get. This air gun is rated at 1,000 feet per second. I know it's going to crush that, no problem. But then we're going to see if it's still accurate. Then we're going to see how it does in the gel. And then you know what's going to happen next. Let's get started. God damn, 12.89. I ended up making no adjustments to the scope, and because of the light weight of these pellets, it was shooting high, but grouped well, half inch. Almost 16 foot-pounds of muzzle energy.
You know what time it is. It's my favorite time. It's time to shoot some clay.
You big dummy.
Gonna have to get another shot. Too low.
Wave from the Winchester, lead free. Started about halfway through the gel, maybe 7 inches. But it was cooking, baby. But through the clay, it bounced off. Didn't make it through the gel once it went through the clay. So it lost all its energy.
The destroyer on the left is shot through gel only. On the right is clay. The middle is your standard destroyer. Nice expansion as always. Same situation, top down view, nice expansion. Now these lead free 4.32 grains, barely any expansion. Right is the clay, middle is your standard, left is gel only. You could only see a little bit of rifling, and even the top down view, barely any expansion whatsoever. Probably great for up close bird headshots.
Well, there you go. There's the long-term review and max velocity test of the Ruger Airhawk .177 brake barrel. The proof is in the pudding, folks. It's still shooting fairly accurate, at least at 10 yards. Blasting them pellets out at 920 feet per second with a lead pellet at 7.4 grains. The lead frees were 1,289 feet per second. Ridiculous. Sounded like firecrackers going off in my basement. But I'll tell you what, I got that gun for $119.99. If you find it for that price, it's a steal. It's a workhorse. It's still doing a great job. Everybody, I hope this gives you some information on the Ruger Airhawk for a long-term update review. I'll catch you all next time.